How do I repair Microsoft Office? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's the question. When I want to open a file in Excel, a dialog box appears. Program error. Excel.exe has generated errors and will be closed by Windows. You will need to restart the program. How do I fix this? It's funny because when I came to this article, I in fact was experiencing a problem with Excel myself. It would open up and then close without actually opening the spreadsheet that I wanted. It's a very important spreadsheet, actually. It was my publication schedule, the spreadsheet that I use with my team to coordinate when articles are published and who's doing what to each article along the way. So that meant I went down this path. And here's where the path starts. It starts in settings. So I'm going to right-click on the start button here, click on settings, click on apps, click on installed apps, wait a few minutes for that to populate depending on how many programs you have installed. It can take a minute or two. I'm going to scroll down now to Microsoft 365. Now you'll notice that there are two of them. I believe the first one that's not including the word Office is the one that's pre-installed on the machine that basically redirects you to the free versions of Office Online. It's the second one that we care about, Microsoft 365 Office. On the right-hand side, we have an ellipsis. We'll click on that and then click on Advanced Options. That's where all the magic lies. Scroll down and you'll see that there is a section here called Reset. That's where we're going to do what we're going to do. Each of these is progressively more impactful. For example, I'm going to hit Repair. That's a great place to start. And you can see there's progress bar. It does whatever the repair does. And then there's a checkbox right next to the repair. This may fix some problems and not others. The good news about repair is that it's not resetting any Outlook settings or any of the other data that's associated with Office itself. If we still have a problem, then we go to reset. In this case, the app's data will be reset, so you may lose your default settings and your history and a few other things in the application. Let's say that that's necessary. I'll click on reset. Same thing, progress bar, something happens behind the scenes, and we get a checkbox. If the problem went away at this point, then you're good. It is solved for you. Whatever this slightly more aggressive thing did, solved your problem. If it didn't, well, you can tell where we're going by the next item on the list, and I'm not going to actually click it here. The next thing to do, if Office is still not working for you, is to uninstall it. You can uninstall it here, or if you want, use Revo Uninstaller or one of the other uninstallation tools to perhaps slightly more aggressively uninstall whatever Microsoft Office has installed on your machine. But at a minimum, you would do this. And then you would reinstall Microsoft Office from scratch. If none of this helped, then you could be looking at a different kind of problem. It may not be Office itself. I would take the document that you're attempting to open, if a document is involved, and see if you can open it on another installation on another machine of Microsoft Office. If the document itself is corrupted, that could be the cause. And the other thing, this is true for web browsers a lot, but Office also handles what are called add-ins. In other words, these are packages that you can install on top of Office that provide additional functionality. There are add-ins for Word, there are add-ins for Excel. I'm sure that there are add-ins for some of the other Office products as well. Sometimes those can be the cause. So one of the things you might do is uninstall those. Granted, a fresh reinstall of Office without installing those add-ons should be the same result. But if for whatever reason you still have them installed, uninstall them and see if that doesn't make things go better. Hopefully, you'll never need any of this. And it'll just be something you heard about a long time ago. But if you do run into problems, then this would be a good starting point. Now, full disclosure, before we close this out, as it turns out, halfway through this process, when I was doing it for my installation of Office, my machine crashed. And I'm not sure why. There was a lot of things going on, as is typical. So I rebooted the machine, got myself back to the point where I was going through this process, and all of a sudden Excel started working. So perhaps step zero, the step you do before all other steps, should always be reboot your machine. Seems to have helped me. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/5061. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.